Hi. So, sorting. It's quite a common task in the field of programming, but most of us just use two different types. Either we use insertion sort for small arrays or quick sort for larger ones. But why is that? And are there any other algorithms? Well, of course, we know there are. You have bubble sort and all sorts of different ones. But what about the even more alternative algorithms? The sort of algorithms that you have really never ever heard of. The more preposterous programs, so to speak. The more mysterious methods, the more flamboyant functions. I really haven't figured the name out for this one, but can we find the hidden holy grail of sorting algorithms? How good is gnome sort? Yes, you heard it right. Gnome sort. According to Wikipedia, of course the most reliable source on the internet, gnome sort was first proposed by an Iranian computer scientist Hamid Sarbazi Azad in the year 2000. I really hope that I pronounced it correctly. So at first it was called stupid sort, which really doesn't sound very promising, but it was later renamed the gnome sort. As you might be wondering, why gnome sort of all the names that you can choose? Well, there is actually a pretty funny story for that. See, apparently, the gnome sort algorithm sorts its arrays similarly to how a garden gnome would sort his line of flower pots. Really, I'm not making this up. That is actually what it says on Wikipedia. So first, he looks at the flower pot in front of him, and the flower pot one to the left. Then, if these two pots are in the right order, he moves one pot to the right. If they are not in the right order, he swaps them and moves one to the left. If there is no pot to the left, he steps one to the right instead, and if there is no pot to the right, he is done. Sounds simple enough, right? But is it fast? Well, as you can imagine, if the array is already sorted, the sorting algorithm does nothing, basically. It just steps through the array, one step at a time, and so complexity would be linear. If the array is sorted in the opposite direction though, which is the worst case scenario, the algorithm has to traverse back and forth through the array completely for every single entry, and so the complexity would be quadratic. So on average, this algorithm is slower than quicksort, which has a complexity of O and log n. But really, how much slower is it? Because insertion sort also has a quadratic complexity, yet insertion sort is a lot faster than quicksort for small arrays. So how does gnome sort compare? Now, I have prepared three algorithms in C. So, gnome sort, of course, quicksort, and insertion sort. As you can see here, gnome sort isn't a particularly hard algorithm to implement. Just one function that is a couple of lines in size, we define an index, we iterate over the array using that index, and we reverse and swap here, if the value of the array at the index is not in the right order, as we discussed earlier. The other two algorithms are also basic C implementations, but I will not go into detail on these. So let us compare. First, we will measure the time it takes to sort a random array of 10 elements 100 times using all three algorithms. From this, gnome sort takes 14 microseconds. Quicksort takes 12 microseconds, and surprisingly, insertion sort only takes 6 microseconds. So for small arrays, insertion sort is the fastest by a lot. Now, we already knew that when it comes to quicksort versus insertion sort, but it is surprising to see that gnome sort, which is also relatively simple, is more than twice as slow as insertion sort, and therefore even slower than quicksort. Now, let's do the same thing but with larger arrays of 100 elements. Maybe gnome sort will shine here? Well, we found that gnome sort takes 604 microseconds to do it. Quicksort takes 193 microseconds. An insertion sort, well, it only takes 168 microseconds. So it is now 3 times faster than gnome sort. I did definitely not expect this. And lastly, let's do it once more, but with even larger arrays of 1000 elements. Here we found that gnome sort takes, get this, 48,585 microseconds. Quicksort only takes 2800 microseconds, exactly by the way, and insertion sort takes 8,841 microseconds. So quicksort is now finally the fastest, by a lot by the way, but also insertion sort is now almost 6 times faster than gnome sort. we can really see the quadratic tendency of Gnome Sword here, which seems to appear a lot faster than that of Insurgent Sword. Now, in principle, both algorithms behave very similarly. They both go forwards through the array and then swap entries backwards until the array is in order again. But where Insurgent Sword just kind of moves out of place entries forwards in the array, Gnome Sword swaps them backwards. And this causes many more assignment operations without any benefit whatsoever. So no wonder it was called Stupid Sword to begin with. So yeah, is Gnome Sword the holy grail of sorting algorithms? Well, certainly not. It is basically just Insurgent Sword, but worse in every single way. But it was fun to explore this wacky thing, and if performance is not a concern, then it would certainly be a lot of fun to use it. And yeah, that was it for today, everyone. Let me know what you think of this new series, and of course, like, subscribe, it helps me out so much. Alright, this was No Number Man. Hope you all have a wonderful rest of your day. Bye bye!